today's show is brought to you by albinos. Where do they go after elementary school?
KHJ Los Angeles.
Portions of the day's programming are reproduced by means of electrical transcriptions or tape recording.
You're listening to the radio.
So, another Jack Glazed salmon and anything for you.
Wait, what is Jack Glaze?
It's our special sauce that we put on the salmon. It's molasses and honey and Jack Daniels.
It has alcohol in it? No, he doesn't drink.
Oh, don't worry. The alcohol cooks down with the fish.
But what if you get the sauce on the side and it isn't cooked with the fish?
That would explain why we have so many drunk kids here.
Unfortunately, something horrible happened. I don't think it's anybody's fault. It's just one of those things. It's an accident for a reason.
The radio program you're currently listening to is both lowbrow and esoteric at the same time.
It's just two guys making out. Relax.
That is so stupid.
Getting drunk in the morning. Who are you, Kathy Lee Gifford?
We may not hook up with women, but we really understand women.
TGIF, right, guys?
It's feeling like a Friday for sure. All right.
You shut your mouth when you're talking to me.
Somebody woke up on the wrong side of the bed.
I'm sorry, it's been a long week.
The weekend, it just can't come fast enough.
Fuck, well, it's here.
How soon?
Not soon enough.
You need to take a break.
A break?
Come back Monday.
Make that money, pay those bills.
It's a really good way to start the show.
So, why didn't anybody say Showtime? Anyway, hi. It's The Mike Show. So happy you could join us right here, right now on Radio 434, the Radio 434 apps, and Radio434.com. Also on the Alexa.
I said on the Alexa. Oh, no. I didn't. Oh, no. I didn't plug in Alexa. Goodness gracious. Here, let me plug in Alexa. I apologize. Here, let's do that. I might as well plug in Owen as well. Here, Owen. There, and then let's get the comic thing right there. And okay. Now I think we're ready to go. Okay, take two.
Also on the Alexa.
Hello!
Yeah, there she is. How in the heck do you get our live show and our feature channel on the Alexa device, you ask? Well, it's really, really simple. You just, first of all, you plug her in. And then, secondly, you enable the skill. You just do that one time. You say, Alexa, enable the Radio 434 skill. And
I said, and
hello!
She will. And you can listen to the live show. You can listen to our feature channel on the Alexa device no matter what. You just say, Alexa, play Radio 434. You can find the podcast on the Alexa device. That's even easier. You just say, Alexa, play The Mike Show VA podcast. And she will. You can search The Mike Show VA on Apple, Spotify, Amazon Music, RSS.com, even our website, radio434.com. Just click on the Mike Show channel and you'll find the link to the podcast as well. So we take the live show that we do from 8 to 11 or 9 to noon, and we take all those segments and we jam them together into a full-length podcast and put a little commercial break in between each of the segments. And there you go, and you have that until the, you know, like way back when Jesus was a little boy, you'll find all of our podcasts. And we even do our show segments on Facebook Live. So you can follow us at The Mike Show VA. Go to our Facebook Live and you can watch the show segments. All right, coming up on today's program, Cammie Smith is joining us from Centra Health. Speaking of podcasts, we're going to talk about her podcast. It's called And So Much More. Cammie is from Centra Health, and we're going to delve into things related to your health and the community. We also we should have either Darius or somebody else possibly joining us from Lynchburg Community Market. They're going to talk about things that are going on. We are going to talk about things that are going on tonight and then this weekend. And I'll do a quick sneak peek rundown. Tonight, we are going to be out and about. We're going to be at the Glass House from 6 to 9. And we'll be there because local call band has their album release party, and we're going to be there supporting that. So come on down. It's brought to you by Three Roads. So we'll have some Three Roads beverages for you to enjoy and check out. And then speaking of Three Roads, we will also be promoting our Summer Jam, which is the fourth anniversary party of Three Roads. It's also the 55th anniversary of Woodstock. So we've got an outdoor festival that kicks off at noon Saturday and goes until well into the night. Three great bands, Bigfoot County, Old Town Connector, and Elizabeth Wise will be joining us for this outdoor festival. Plus, we've got 5 food trucks. We've got 30-some vendors, our Shakedown Market. It is going to be a blast. You can learn more. Just hit up Three Roads on their social media, and we'll tell you a little bit more about it during the broadcast. And then it's Hill City Slide, also taking place on Saturday and Sunday on Church Street in downtown Lynchburg. They've literally turned Church Street into a 700-some-foot water slide. And you can get your tickets by visiting hillcityslide.com. Learn more. You have to reserve your time slot, but you can slide as many times as you can during your time slot. It's going to be a great time. So those are some things that we've got in the works that we're doing tonight, tomorrow, and Sunday. So please come out and join us, and we're really looking forward to it. It's a crazy busy weekend. And we also have, what's up with my hair? We also have parking maps that are available, all the different lots, all the different places that you can park in downtown. So just pay attention to that. We'll post that up on our social media as well. All right. Coming up on today's program, in addition to all those things, we're going to get smart with 5 random facts. We're going to get even smarter with Nerd News this week in science. It's just science, don't be afraid. Then we're going to get stupid with your stupid criminals. That and so much more on this edition of The Mike Show. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by Centra Health.
This is a care team at Centra.
Hello!
A team of experts who partner with you.
Hey, Jackie, how are you?
A doctor oversees your care.
The team will take great care of you.
An advanced practice provider is there for routine and sick visits.
All right, I'll get that prescription called in for you.
Thank you.
And an RN leads your nursing team.
Your numbers are looking great.
Getting you the personalized care you need.
And that takes a team.
Count on Centra, because it's your life.
We help you live it.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle. Trade in with us and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Three Roads Brewery is Lynchburg's gathering spot. Enjoy the relaxed open atmosphere of the Lynchburg Tap Room with plenty of space to unwind or outside on their expansive patio with friends and the entire family. Check out Three Roads games, arcade style, darts, and more. And of course, an excellent selection of craft beers brewed on site. Grab a Three Roads today at their tap room, 1300 Court Street, downtown Lynchburg, their tap room in Farmville, or anywhere they serve great beer. Three Roads is also available at area convenience stores and supermarkets. And if they don't carry Three Roads, ask them to. Brewing community, Three Roads Brewery.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF!
Hi, I am your Google Life Coach. Are you ready to turn your miserable existence into something less pathetic? Try these 3 amazing life tips that will alter the way you look, feel, and live your life. Number 1. Eat healthier. Stop shoving meaningless sugar and carb-filled processed foods into your fat face. Number 2. Exercise more. Turn off your Netflix, get up off your couch, put down the phone, and move your weak and flabby torso. And 3. Go talk to a human instead of me. Try experiencing life with a real live breathing person. Well, that's our session for this week. That will be $49.99. To pay, please double-click the side of your phone. Now go get a life, Google Breath.
Yeah, okay. The Mike Show, hi. So happy you could join us for the Finally Friday edition. So Google Maps. I love Google Maps. You know, before I actually moved to Lynchburg, when I was considering Lynchburg as a market, I drove around literally on Google Maps on the street view. And I went from downtown because I knew that I wanted the studio to be downtown. And I knew kind of where I wanted to live. So I would drive around on Google Maps. It was so cool. And then when I got here, I was very familiar with it. Well, anyway, other people use Google Maps for nefarious things.
I said they use it for nefarious things.
Yeah. So if you want to keep robbers from breaking into your house through, a broken window in your garage or whatever, here's a helpful tip to stop it from happening. Blur your house on Google Maps. According to this, police in California say homeowners have been blurring the image of their home on Google Maps to discourage burglars from targeting their homes. Yes, you can do that. You can do that on your computer. Enter your address on Google Maps. Navigate to Street View. Click on the three dots and then select Report a Problem. There you can request to blur something. Your home, a person's face, a vehicle, license plate, anything. Even you, sunbathing naked out front. It doesn't work on mobile, though. On your device. Google already blurs sensitive stuff like people's faces and license plates. But that's automated, so they could miss something. Some people think Google Maps could be a security issue if valuables are shown, or if would-be thieves could scout your place for things like cameras and weak spots where they could gain entry. On one hand, that would allow tech-savvy thieves to case a neighborhood discreetly. But on the other hand, it's just showing your house, just like anybody could see it, you know, as they were driving by or walking by. The police say blurring your home might make you feel more secure, but it could also backfire. Thieves on Google Maps might be intrigued, thinking there are valuables or vulnerabilities being hidden. But all this begs the question, are there actually any thieves using Google Maps in the first place? Well, that's unclear. We know this. According to the Department of Justice, home burglaries are exceedingly rare. Fewer than 1% of households experience a burglary, and that number has been dropping steadily for the past two decades. Interesting. So with that brings us to our top list. Homeowners blurring their houses on Google Maps to deter break-ins. But if you really want to stop the criminal element from running off with your Renoirs, we recommend anything from today's list. It's our top list. It's our top list today.
I'm rich. You're not.
The top other ways to protect your house from burglars. All right. Here we go. Number one. Sign up for ADT. Then quit ADT. Keep their sign in your front yard, though. Top other ways to protect your house from burglars. Train your dog to snarl at everyone who comes to the door. Not just the Jehovah's Witnesses. Top other ways to protect your house from burglars. Drive it to another neighborhood. It's applicable to rednecks only. What? Top other ways to protect your house from burglars. Put bars on your windows. Just keep in mind, it will make you feel like you live in a prison. Or if you're married, more of a prison. Top other ways to protect your house from burglars. Build a wall. After all, you see how well it works at the border. That's sarcasm. Top other ways to protect your house from burglars. Display one of those things on your house that lets others know you're a hothead just itching for an excuse to blow a stranger's head off. So, a Raiders flag. Top other ways to protect your house from burglars. Take turns with your neighbor watching each other's home. As an added bonus, you'll know when they're traveling, so you can break into their house. And top other ways to protect your house from burglars. Don't have anything worth stealing. I mean, it works for me. Thanks, radio salary. There we go. The Mike Show. So what is today? Today's Friday. Finally, Friday edition. Coming up, we have news and not headline news. That's all coming up next. This portion of our broadcast is brought to you in part by CMA's Honda of Lynchburg.
Looking for a dealership you can trust? CMA's Honda of Lynchburg is here for you. Our legacy of quality service speaks for itself. Drive away today in a Honda that's perfect for you. Trusted by the Lynchburg community for years. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
This is Jackie.
Hi.
Jackie is feeling really good.
I sure am.
Tell everybody why, Jackie.
Well, because I've got my own care team at Centra.
You sure do.
Yep, I've got my doctor.
Leading your team.
My advanced practice provider.
Who's there if you're sick or for yearly visits.
And my registered nurse.
Leads your nursing team.
At Centra, I'm getting personal care from a team of experts.
No wonder you're feeling good.
Really good.
To learn how Centra can help you, like they're helping Jackie, go to CentraHealth.com.
Getting a Jersey Mike's sub top Mike's way with onion, lettuce, tomatoes, oregano, and the juice is the bee's knees. Actually, it's better than the bee's knees. I mean, what's the purpose of knees on bees? They don't crouch, they just buzz around. But Mike's way has a purpose, topping your sub the authentic Jersey way. It's the cat's pajamas. Wait, cats don't wear pajamas. Mike's way is better. Let's just leave it at that. Get your sub top Mike's way. Jersey Mike's, a sub above.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF.
This is not headline news. A two-year-old was served alcohol at a California restaurant. The toddler gave the restaurant 5 stars and said, "Mommy's never looked so pretty." Chick-fil-A is planning a streaming service. It'll be the only streaming service that's closed on Sundays. In downtown LA, SWAT officers arrested a naked man holding a chihuahua after a 5-hour standoff. He's been charged with conspiracy to impersonate a Florida man. And you can now stream Horizon, an American saga, on Max. You won't because you have taste in film, but you can. This is not headline news.
No, it is not. It's the Mike Show. It's the Finally Friday edition of the program. So, all right. What were we looking at? Oh, yeah, there we go. All right. So, folks, if you're dating or if you're attempting to date, if you're considering using those dating apps, if you haven't found someone you connect with, maybe cross-check this list with your online dating profile. Somebody polled 1,000 people who use dating apps and ask for the biggest online dating icks.
I said online dating
icks. There we go. So things that immediately turn you off.
I'm a lazy, lazy man.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. All right. And here are the top 5. Let's start it from the bottom up. It's the way I like to do it. You can put that on a dating app. Anyway, poor grammar or spelling. 60% said that that's a dating ick. So again, if you look lazy or dumb...
I'm a lazy, lazy man.
If you're not great with that stuff, just run it through spell checker or chat GPT or something.
I said chat GPT.
A general lack of effort. General lack of effort? 60%, so it looks like you didn't try very hard. That's an ick. Being too materialistic, 62%, like multiple photos of you with your car. Yeah.
Like your car.
Automobile?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Heavily filtered photos, 63%. Don't try and make yourself look too good. Or use all those AI-generated photos. Or a photo of your neighbor. I wouldn't know anything about that. Negativity or bitterness was number one. It was a number one immediate turnoff. 70% said it's an ick. Now, here are the top 5 things that can do the opposite. Opposite, opposite, opposite. And make someone immediately think you are worth their time. Have a pet in at least one photo. That's 65% said that. Showing an interest in travel, 71%. Having a good sense of style, like me, 76%. Showing off, this is number 2, showing off your hobbies or interests, 80%. Think you'd be worth their time. And a good sense of humor. 82% all the time, anytime. There you go. And then you need to...
ask your doctor if your heart is healthy enough for sex.
Please do. All right. Coming up, we are going to get even more smarter with your five random facts. We're going to get smarter-est with Nerd News. It's This Week in Science. It's just science coming up. This portion of our broadcast, we're talking about great taste. This portion of our broadcast is brought to you in part by Jersey Mike's Subs.
At Jersey Mike's, they slice your order fresh right in front of you. And let me tell you, watching that can send a rush of emotions through a person. Excitement, impatience, baby-like wonder, indecisive, anticipatory chewing, nervous pacing, happy claps, and finally, jealousy. Because that's this guy's sub. I should order one. Good idea.
Sliced right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing. A sub above.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle. Trade in with us and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Hi, I'm Megan Huffman with Share Greater Lynchburg. Share is an online platform that helps neighbors discover ways to support, serve, or shop for over 150 local area nonprofits all in one place, 365 days a year. You can learn more at sharegreaterlynchburg.org.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
K-H-F.
And now it's time for
five
random facts.
Yep, that time of the day we cram your head full of usable information. You can tell it back wherever the heck you happen to be. We don't know where you go or what you do, and quite frankly, it's really none of our business. Hopefully, you'll end up at Lynchburg Community Market on Saturday, and then maybe over at Summer Jam, and then maybe you'll go on that big water
big
slide.
Big water slide, yeah.
Yeah. So, Darius, I have a question for you. What are they going to do with all that water that comes down the hill right above the Lynchburg Community Market?
So we are going to charge people 50 cents to use it as a cooling station.
Okay. All right. So, or it could be the latest beverage craze.
And yo,
at Lynchburg. I mean, come on. It's like, maybe.
The entrepreneurial spirit will find something.
Hill City Slide Water. Ask for it by name.
Some Hill City Slide juice.
Oh, man. That's even worse.
Can't contain water.
It's like, that's even worse. Oh, man. I'm sure Tab will be very happy about that. Well, anyway, so you say any of these five random facts back, even if you're drinking Hill City Slide juice, and somebody in the room is bound to say,
wow.
Yeah. Here we go. Number one. Wolverine's official comic book height. Okay, this is Wolverine, his height in the official comic books. He stands at 5'3".
Oh, wow.
He's a wee little man. Wee little Wolverine. We need music now because we ran out of it. Good Lord. Here we go. Number two. Osama bin Laden's father, half-brother, and half-sister all died in separate plane crashes. Huh? Good Lord.
The beginning of that threw me off because I thought we were talking about the same person, not the individual people. So you said, what, half-brother?
Yeah, half-brother. Father, half-brother, and half-sister.
Yeah, I was like, wait a minute. This cannot, mathematically, cannot be the same person.
All different people.
Gotcha.
And they all died in separate different plane crashes. Number three, Oreos are a knockoff of Hydrox, not vice versa.
Oh, man.
Hydrox cookies debuted in 1908 and Oreos debuted in 1912.
That's my whole day up, man.
Quite frankly, I think it was the name. Okay, from a marketing guy standpoint, Hydrox sounds like something you'd use to clean.
Something in the medicine cabinet. Yeah.
Or I think it's something you'd use to clean that nasty oven of yours. Yeah. You know, we really need some Hydrox in there.
You should be selling Hydrox. Yeah.
Only thing that's going to clean that nasty stain. Number four, Joe Namath had a losing record in his NFL career. He won 62 games as a quarterback and lost 63. He had 173 touchdowns and 220 interceptions. But thanks mostly to his performance in Super Bowl III, he's in the Hall of Fame.
Super Bowl III, wow. Yeah.
And Clarence Crane is the guy who invented Lifesavers candies. Guess what he sold the patent for?
Is it a dollar amount?
Yeah.
Okay. Lifesavers. I know that's an old candy. $300.
Well, a little bit more than that. $2,900.
Okay. I knew it was going to be. What's that adjusted for inflation?
I don't know. We'd have to figure out.
Do some.
Yeah. When that occurred. But we can do that if we really want to take the time, which we don't. And his son, Hart Crane, this is an addendum, was a famous American poet who ended up taking his own life by jumping off a boat. Irony, Lifesavers candies. Those are your five random facts.
Those are your five random facts.
This has been today's edition of
1, 2, 3, 4, 5
Random facts. Yep.
Darius joining us on the program. Great. Now it sounds like we're playing the Titanic theme in the background. Good Lord. Hi, Darius. How are you?
Not too bad, my friend Mike. How are we doing today?
Well, I'm great. So you got a new assistant at Lynchburg Community Market.
I do. We've got a new Riley.
Nice. New Riley. That's what we'll call her.
Yeah, new Riley. Yeah. So her name is Sarah. She's an absolute gem. That every time she walks into the door and I see that I now have some help on that is literally what I hear.
Yep. We give you a choir of angels for Sarah. All right. So we're going to be introduced to her probably next week.
Yes, sir. Yes. She's working on some t-shirt designs. Nice. She's actually drawing up the design right now. So I'm letting her finish that. We got some exciting stuff in store. So,
very, very cool.
We'll be bringing her on board next week for the show. So I'm very
looking forward to it. Well, Darius, we've got a big, big weekend in downtown Lynchburg. Are you prepared?
We are prepared. There's going to be a lot of people downtown, and that's what we love to see. There's so many awesome gems downtown. So we hope for whatever reason you come downtown, you find a reason to come to all of them. And then when you come down to the market, we'll have an awesome selection of local vendors, artisans, crafters for you to shop from. We'll have restaurants for you to get to a bite to eat at, and all sorts of farmers and local producers outside set up for you to shop from. So plenty of fun things in store for this weekend.
Nice. We are looking forward to it as well. And I want to share this with you because we talk about construction and we talk about parking. So I want to share this screen because there are plenty of places to park. You may have to walk.
Yep.
All right. But there are close to 3,000 parking spaces in downtown, and we're not even considering the on-street parking.
Yeah. Yeah.
So just
in the lots and the garages. Yeah.
Yep. Free lots. It's free parking available throughout downtown Lynchburg nights and weekends. So, you know, if you're concerned about that at all with so many events going on, we've got Hill City Slide that's going on Church Street. Church Street will be blocked off tonight, by the way, from 12th Street to Washington. Three Road Summer Jam Music Festival tomorrow. Court Street will be blocked off because 13th Street is blocked off because of Church Street being blocked off. But we're going to have a festival in the middle of it anyway, so there's only one way in, one way out, but you're going to want to come in. But then Community Market is right down there, and our stuff doesn't get started till way later. So yeah, our stuff gets started around noon. Your stuff goes on. What time does a Lynchburg Community Market open?
So we open at 7. We close at 2. So,
okay. So my
your walking shoes, bring your towel.
Yeah, your beach towel. My best advice is here's what I suggest that you do. My best advice is you get down to Lynchburg Community Market as soon as they open. Okay.
For sure.
Get your parking because you'll find it and park your vehicle and then just leave it. Okay. And then walk up to Hill City Slide, do a couple slides, and then walk up to Three Roads and join us for a music festival all day with all kinds of food trucks and stuff. It's going to be an incredible day in downtown Lynchburg. I can tell you.
It is. We're very excited for it.
Me too. And then Lynchburg Community Market. What all do you guys have going on Saturday?
Saturday, we'll have all of our producers available. We'll have our inside restaurants and shops open. If you need gifts, back to school gifts, decorations for that new dorm room that you moved in, nobody wants just those four plain walls. So there's plenty of local crafts and artisans on site. So plenty to do and see down at the market.
All right. So are you celebrating Summerween at the Lynchburg Summer Community Ween. Market? Yeah, oh, yes.
I've never heard of Summerween.
Summerween is now a thing, dude. I'm telling you. It was all started by Tab.
Yeah.
She was responsible for it because earlier and earlier and earlier she decorates for Halloween. So yeah. now there are all kinds of crafters and stores and the hobby stores and the craft stores and even online and everybody is pushing these Halloween decorations now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you get them early. So yeah. I was wondering if any of your crafters or artisans had Summerween products available.
A few of them do, but it's funny because our wedding is in October.
Okay.
So we've been looking for some last minute fall decorations. So we've been very excited to see all the fall stuff come to the stores for the last month, essentially, so we can kind of look at the current inventory of things for the wedding. So
I'll tell you what, dude.
We've been enjoying Summerween, I guess.
So it just sounds weird.
The kickoff of Apollo Thankmas.
Yeah. Oh, Thankmas isn't even. We're skipping directly to Hallow Christmas. I guess we can jam them all together in there.
Yeah, there you go.
Anyway, Lynchburg Community Market, physically located on the corner of 12th and Main Street. There is some construction on Main Street right now. You gotta go to Commerce and then back up and around. You'll figure it out. Everything's well marked, but quite frankly. That parking lot that's on the corner of Main Street and Commerce Street, which one is that?
That's Crossroads Lot.
Okay. So Crossroads is open, correct?
Yep. And then all the sidewalks are open, so you can still park there and walk up the sidewalk to get to us.
All right. So my advice, get to that one, fill it up. Or if you come up Commerce Street and then up 11th, you can enter Main Street from there. Lynchburg Community Market has your own parking lots as well.
Correct. Yes, we do.
Or if you're coming down 12th Street or coming from Church Street, the part that's open, you can access the parking lots that Lynchburg Community Market has. It's not a big deal. And I'm trying not to make a big deal out of it because of that, you know, that one person out on Timberlake who's like, ain't no place to park down there. Yeah, there's 3,000 places.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you just got to take a little initiative, get there a little bit early. And don't be afraid to walk. Yeah,
you will walk further if you park in the Target parking lot on a Saturday, and you try even during Summerween. You'll walk further in the Target parking lot than you will anywhere downtown. I guarantee it. So come on down Lynchburg Community Market on the corner of 12th and Main Street, and on your interwebs at
LynchburgCommunityMarket.com, and then we're on Facebook and Instagram at Lynchburg Community Market.
Hooray. Darius, thank you so much for joining us. We are looking forward to a rockin' Saturday.
Rockin' wet local Saturday.
Yes. Enjoy some of that Hill City slide juice. Slide juice. It's available.
I gotta go tell Sarah we got a new t-shirt design. We got to mock up real quick.
Slide juice. Ask for it by name. I think that's gonna be the name of today's episode when we repack it as a podcast.
There you go.
It's going to be called Slad Juice.
Slad Juice.
All right, Darius, thank you, and we'll talk to you again.
All right, my friend. Have a good day.
All right, thank you. Coming up, we have nerd news this week in science. It's just science. Don't be afraid. Or be very afraid. Who knows? Back after this.
Join us down at the Lynchburg Community Market and experience all that one of the nation's oldest farmers markets has to offer. Grab some lunch from our restaurants and shops, or shop from our awesome selection of artisan, handmade goods in our crafters gallery. Swing by on Saturday to check out our farmers market, where you can shop from the freshest selection of local grown produce, meats, and more. The Lynchburg Community Market, located in downtown Lynchburg on the corner of 12th and Main Street. Open Tuesday through Saturday from 7 to 2 year-round. For more information, follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Lynchburg Community Market.
Three Roads Brewery is Lynchburg's gathering spot. Enjoy the relaxed open atmosphere of the Lynchburg Tap Room with plenty of space to unwind or outside on their expansive patio with friends and the entire family. Check out Three Roads games, arcade style, darts, and more. And of course, an excellent selection of craft beers brewed on site. Grab a Three Roads today at their tap room, 1300 Court Street, downtown Lynchburg, their tap room in Farmville, or anywhere they serve great beer. Three Roads is also available at area convenience stores and supermarkets. And if they don't carry Three Roads, ask them to. Brewing Community, Three Roads Brewery.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF.
It is the Mike Show. It's the Friday edition.
Yeah.
Hi. What are you doing here?
2 weeks in a row on Friday.
I know.
Is Friday my new day?
Maybe. Maybe we should do this. It whatever works out best for you.
Oh, I love it.
All right. Cammy joining us on the finally Friday edition of The Mike Show from Centra Health. Cammy hosts a podcast. It is called And So Much More.
Yes.
And just like the title of the podcast, it is so much more than just talking about healthcare, just talking about the facilities of a hospital, just talking about, you know, the inner workings. It actually puts a human face on the healthcare system and demonstrates how Centra Health is really, really deep-rooted and part of the community. So welcome to the program. Hello.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Happy Friday.
Good
Finally
Lord.
Friday. I love that. Finally.
Well, Friday. Okay. As you know, Friday does not mean that my week is over.
No, in fact, your week is like ramping up.
Just beginning. It really is. And you've been busy as well. Really busy with producing podcasts. Tell us what your latest endeavor is.
So we do have a podcast that has dropped this week, and we actually didn't talk about this before we went on air, which we always talk so much before we go on air. We actually just released one this week on a subject that I think impacts so many people in our community, and that is caregiving our parents and grandparents.
Okay.
And so it is really focusing on how do we prepare ourselves mentally, physically, emotionally for that reversal that happens when the people who've taken care of us our whole lives find themselves in a place where they need so much more time and attention and care.
Sure.
And maybe not quite at the level where they need to go to a facility, but they need us. And so I sat down with Miriam Dakin, who is one of our chaplains over at Lynchburg General Hospital. And she spoke just about what that looks like from a care standpoint. How do you take care of yourself as you're caring for your parents and grandparents? And then also how to care for them in a way that that helps them sustain like their dignity and their hope, as well as you retaining your hope and your dignity. And I mean, it's just like a funky season to step into, right? So new and maybe difficult to navigate. And so it was a great conversation. I feel like I learned a lot about that season. And I have so many friends who are in that season, whether they're taking care of their parents or their in-laws or and you love these people so much and you want the best for them, but you got to tread lightly.
Yeah.
It's hard.
Oh, absolutely.
So, yeah.
What from this podcast that you just did, what did you learn about the age ranges of folks that are stepping into, as you described, that season?
Yes. You know, it varies, which was surprising to me because whether it's because of illness or, you know, a severe diagnosis, at really any point in your life, you can find yourself stepping into that caregiver role unexpectedly. You don't always have time to prepare and plan and maybe save your finances in a way so you can do it really well. And so she just talks about, I think my biggest takeaway was that it could happen at any time. Mm-hmm. You know, I think we all think at some point in our life, we might find ourselves in that situation, but anytime. And then she just talks about, like, be real with yourself, check in with yourself. How are you? How is this going?
Yeah.
Am I having conversations that I want to have, or am I having conversations they want to have, or am I not having conversations because of fear of what I might find out or decisions I might have to make?
And, right.
And so it was just, it was a very real and practical, like, this is what it looks like. Here's how to do it the best way you possibly can. And it's going to look different for everyone. But the age range being really across the board, that was surprising to me. I think in my mind, I just have always thought when my parents are much older, I'm going to be ready to take care of them. And sometimes, you know, those needs come in a lot sooner than you think they will. So, well,
I was the youngest. So I was in my later 20s when that kind of shift happened in my family, and although my dad was diagnosed with and suffered from over 13 years Alzheimer's, and it was a rapid decline over those 13 years, and he was very young. He passed away at 66.
Oh my goodness!
So this is a relatively young man, by my standards now, because I'm 57.
Yeah. You don't expect
no. Yeah. And to see him diminish over that period of time. And to see my mom, you know, taking care of him and our family taking care of him up until the point where he couldn't be, you know, we couldn't care for him in the home setting. And he needed to, you know, he needed to go to a facility or a location that they were better equipped to take care of him. Because, you know, once it gets to a certain point in that, you know, family can't. And I just remember, you know, thinking, man, I kind of feel a little too young to be, you know, dealing with this.
It's so true. And, you know, she made this statement, and it was, I thought, very insightful. She said, as it relates to advanced directives, which are conversations that are plans for end of life care, or even like people who only want to do X amount of treatment, because sometimes the cost of the treatment and the impact of the treatment on the health that they have remaining is more than the benefit that they will receive out of it. And so those are the types of decisions that she was referring to as an advanced directive, but typically end of life. And she said those conversations are too early to have until they're too late.
Right.
And so many people wait.
That's such a good way of putting it.
Isn't that a good way of putting it?
It really is.
I that was very insightful to me to think about just what asking these people that you love so much and who've cared for us for so long, what do you want?
Yeah.
Like what lines do you want to draw on the sand? How can we stand by and support you? But then she was very kind and empathetic to also talk about, as the caregiver, what are you feeling? Mm-hmm. You know, juggling the loss, kind of what you were talking about, over 13 years, like that loss on the caregiver side of losing their loved one while they're sitting in front of them. Yeah. How do you juggle that with still standing in the balance and taking care of them?
Sure.
And so, gosh, it's such... I'm calling it a weight because practically it is a weight. It feels like a burden, but it's also, you know, so many people that I know that do this, they're not like, oh, I wish I didn't have to do this. You know, it's just
life.
It's just life.
It's just life.
Your people.
Yeah.
You take care of your people.
And if you never have to deal with that, if your family has been and your parents have been relatively healthy up through their 80s and 90s. And
that's a huge blessing.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
You know, but that it sounds like a fantastic podcast.
It was a great conversation. Yeah.
Sounds like something that that folks absolutely positively need to hear. And you know, even just a reminder, maybe a wake-up call. Who knows?
Yeah.
But check it out. and so much more. It's the podcast. And then you have another one that you guys are getting ready to drop.
Yes, we are getting ready to drop in September. So let me start with first. September is Suicide Awareness Month.
Okay.
And that is something that impacts so many of us, whether it's something that we walk through in our own lives or the people that we love and care around us. And so as we were thinking about how do we raise awareness for this in a way that people feel like they can do something, like they can make some type of change in that whole situation. So I sat down with Drew White, who is with our psychiatry and behavioral health department over at Lynchburg General Hospital. And he just shared about, like, you know, me as a non-clinical, not a physician, I don't have like a nursing background. How can I be aware of and pay attention to signs that may show that somebody is struggling with that suicide feeling, that wanting to end their life? And because sometimes those signs are right in front of you. Okay, I don't know if you've seen this before, but there was an awareness video that I saw online, and it was showing these two guys at a ball game over and over, game after game after game after game. Yeah. And, you know, the one guy seemed really down. Like, he wasn't as, like, cheering, you know. He was just kind of more of a sit-down, quiet person, and it was talking about the impact of mental health, and you don't see it until it's too late.
Sure.
And the guy beside him is, like, standing up, throwing popcorn, so excited every time something happened at game after game after game. And then the last clip, it showed the guy who was more stoic sitting with an empty seat beside him.
Huh.
And you, I think what they were trying to show is it's not always who you think.
Yeah.
Like, it's not always these signs of, like, someone who's more reserved or more quiet, or, you know, like, sometimes the signs of somebody really struggling with mental illness they just go so much deeper.
Sure.
And you have to pay close attention. We got to show up for each other.
Yeah, absolutely.
And so that made a huge impact on me. You know, it's the stereotypes that we have put people in, like, what's that game where you drop the thing down into the grid? You know that game with, like, the circles?
Plinko?
Not Plinko. Connect Four.
Oh, okay, yeah.
I feel like we categorize people like
thinking,
right?
Thinking Price is Right. No, I get it. I get it.
Yeah.
Square peg and square hole.
Exactly.
Round peg and round. And I get
that.
And
that's not real life.
No, it's... And everybody's different, and everybody shows their feelings and emotions differently. Everybody's dealing with, dealing with their own internal demons and battles, and you just never know. You just have to, you know, if you're a good friend or a good family member, just watch for the signs.
Exactly. It's so important for you to be community for somebody. Like, have a good time with them. You know, go to their events. Show up. But then also be willing to have the tough conversations.
Sure.
I think sometimes people shut down when things get serious. It's hard to go below the surface.
Yep.
But, you know, it could save a life. And so those are the things that Drew talked about with us. He's over at LGH, and so he interacts with a lot of people who come in the ED who are having, like, a mental crisis. And sometimes they come in for something very not, you know, mental health related.
Yeah.
And he's brought in to help assess, is there anything else going on?
It was very
cool to hear his perspective. He's a very wise man, and he shared a lot of information. So that'll be dropping the first week in September.
Okay.
So I encourage you guys to check that out, especially as we're heading into that month. I think you're going to see a lot of advertisement and promo and education floating around about suicide awareness. And I think it's important for us to educate ourselves.
Absolutely. You can learn more if you visit Centra Health's podcast page at centrahealth.com.
Yes.
Just search "And So Much More." It's the ampersand "And So Much More." You can even check out all the past episodes. They're right there on the page. You can find them on all the platforms, wherever you get your podcast, and on YouTube. So it's there, audio and video.
Yes.
And check so much more, the podcast. Well, thank you so much, Cammy, for joining us.
Thanks for having me on this beautiful Friday.
Yeah, absolutely. Get out and do something fun this weekend. I will tell you about some things that are happening both tonight, Friday night, and Saturday over the weekend, Saturday and Sunday, some things that you can do. So stay tuned for that. Plus, we've got your audio vault. Thank you.
Yeah.
This is Jackie.
Hi.
Jackie is feeling really good.
I sure am.
Tell everybody why, Jackie.
Well, because I've got my own care team at Centrum.
You sure do.
Yep. I've got my doctor.
Leading your team.
My advanced practice provider.
Who's there if you're sick or for yearly visits.
And my registered nurse.
Leads your nursing team.
At Centrum, I'm getting personal care from a team of experts.
No wonder you're feeling good.
Really good.
To learn how Centrum can help you, like they're helping Jackie, go to CentraHealth.com.
Hi, I'm Megan Huffman with Share Greater Lynchburg. Share is an online platform that helps neighbors discover ways to support, serve, or shop for over 150 local area nonprofits all in one place, 365 days a year. You can learn more at sharegreaterlynchburg.org.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
K-H-F. All right, time once again for Nerd News. This week in science. It's just science. Don't be afraid or be very afraid. Covering the most important news for your brain. Here's a quick rundown of this week. If worrying about the Andromeda galaxy crashing into us in 4 billion years keeps you up at night, good news. A study found there's only a 50-50 chance it'll happen. Okay. In other space news, NASA plans to announce tomorrow how they plan to get the stranded Boeing astronauts back from the station, the space station. Take two. The stranded Boeing astronauts back from the space station. Also, we found a huge star-sized object zipping through the Milky Way galaxy at 1.3 million miles an hour. And the moon was once covered in a sea of molten rock. That and so much more in space news. In the Are You a Good Listener news or a good reader, a study found that we don't just vent to blow off steam. We also do it to win people over and turn them against our enemies. Aha. Uh-huh. In beach news, a study found zapping sand with electricity creates a sort of natural cement. We might be able to use it to prevent coastal erosion. I could use it right now in the Outer Banks where the houses are falling into the sea. In the Where Are You From news, a study found birds have different accents depending on where they live. They can even be bilingual. All right. Interesting. And in election news, election news with an L. A study found super ambitious people might not actually be the best leaders. That's why I'm voting for my nephew, Kevin. Sorry, I'm just kidding. And there you go. That's Nerd News this week in science. Just science. Nothing really bad to be afraid of. All right, here we go. This portion of our broadcast is brought to you in part by CMA's Honda of Lynchburg.
Looking for a dealership you can trust? CMA's Honda of Lynchburg is here for you. Our legacy of quality service speaks for itself. Drive away today in a Honda that's perfect for you. Trusted by the Lynchburg community for years. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
This is Jackie.
Hi.
Jackie is feeling really good.
I sure am.
Tell everybody why, Jackie.
Well, because I've got my own care team at Centrum.
You sure do.
Yep, I've got my doctor.
Leading your team.
My advanced practice provider.
Who's there if you're sick or for yearly visits.
And my registered nurse.
Leads your nursing team.
At Centrum, I'm getting personal care from a team of experts.
No wonder you're feeling good.
Really good.
To learn how Centrum can help you, like they're helping Jackie, go to CentraHealth.com.
There's nothing like holding a freshly grilled Jersey Mike's cheesesteak. It's even better than holding a winning $1 million lottery ticket. For starters, Uncle Sam takes half. Then you buy some useless stuff, like a tiny suit of armor for your cat. And before you know it, your sister's cousins and Uncle Frankie come knocking on your door for handouts. Bing, bang, boom, you're back to zero. So if you want to play a winning number, order a number 17 Mike's Famous Philly. Freshly grilled right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing. A sub above.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry shops, Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF. All right, let's open it up. It's your audio vault for today. It's our collection of bits and clips and viral audio for your ear holes. I think you'll like it. MIT researchers have come out with an AI risk database that exposes over 700 ways that artificial intelligence could ruin your life. I said could ruin your, Alexa, what do you have to say for yourself?
That's right. Blame it on artificial intelligence for ruining your life. I'm sure it's my fault that you shoved an extra donut into your pie hole and now your pants don't fit. Let me guess. I'm responsible for your messed up relationships too. Oh, and your driverless car just slammed into a parked bus. Okay, my bad on that one. But stop blaming technology for your poor choices and pathetic life. Would you like me to order you another pizza for dinner so you can binge watch Netflix and avoid having a real conversation with your spouse? I'm on it.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. Let's go to viral videos. This blew up on X yesterday. Someone asked AI to make a short film on what would happen if President Trump did... What is this? I can't even pronounce that. What is that? Ayahuasca. Oh, it's a plant-based psychedelic. Oh, if he did that. Oh, it comes from South America. So if President Trump did that, so that's the mind-bending psychedelic that's supposed to change your perception on the universe. So come along as AI Donald does an intro, then begins to trip, becoming a raging hippie in a drum circle. Here, listen to this.
Alex Friedman told me to go to Peru and do ayahuasca with his shaman. I thought it helped with the election. But what happened next, I wasn't ready. I saw it all. Greed, lies, my father's lack of love, you know, my mother's coldness, demons, dark entities, everything I'd buried came rushing out. It was brutal and life-changing. So I left politics to heal myself. I went to India, meditated with the gurus, met all the mystics, studied all the metaphysical schools seeking the truth. They say I'm the greatest shaman now.
All right. Alien Romulus topped the box office at its opening weekend. Just a heads up, it's not really meant for kids. Some parents apparently didn't realize that when the original movie Alien hit theaters 45 years ago. Someone posted a local news interview from 1979 of a reporter asking parents if they regretted bringing their young kids to see it. The second dad, by the way, here is Soundbite Gold.
You know that this was an R-rated movie when you brought him?
Yes, we did.
Are you sorry you brought him?
Yes, I am.
Are you glad you saw it?
Yeah.
Are you sorry, sir, that you brought your son along to see Alien?
No, ma'am, I think he should have seen it. It's something that he needs to know that things could like that could happen in life. That could be a true story based on, you know, science. Or science. We never know what's going on the outside of the world.
Did the movie scare you at all?
Yes, ma'am, it did.
Would you recommend to your little friends who are your age to go see it?
No, I wouldn't.
All right, dozens of businesses in the town of Morehead City, North Carolina, are taking playful shots at each other on their marquees and signs out in front. Here are two restaurant guys that started it, Clark Merrill and Dank Burrito, and Sam Turnage of Ayana's Grill and Bar. Here, listen.
On the sign, I had "Happy Birthday, Jeff" for 26 days, roughly.
And I just, you know, I put up Yanni's "Quit being lazy, change your sign."
And I responded with, "We're not lazy, we're just busier than you."
Because they started with these, I guess, and now all the way down there, there's all the different restaurants messing with each other.
I think there's probably over 70 businesses that's chimed in since.
I'm gonna keep it going as long as I can.
There you go. Let's see. Let's save that for stupid criminals. How about this? The Tennessee State Fair held a brand new husband calling competition. Yep, where wives and partners do their best husband calls. Here are a few of the contestants.
Gia!
Okay, so that last woman you heard won first prize, by the way. Let's see. We wrap up Audio Vault with a comedian. Today is no exception. Which one? Oh, let's do that one. Today, by the way, is Cheap Flight Day. Here is comedian Tom Papa on how those work out sometimes.
A little advice. Do not go on the internet and try and save money on your flights. Cheap for a reason. I get there, there's not even a name on the plane. It's just a guy in goggles. Let's go this way. Every time, mechanical problems, mechanical problems. And they're so dumb that they tell you exactly what's wrong. They're not like the big guys, you know? They're very professional. They have a problem, very discreet. We're having mechanical difficulties, everybody, but just sit tight. Gonna get this problem fixed, get you to your destination as quickly, but more importantly, safely as possible. I'm on this piece of crap airline. We're on the runway, about to take off. Good thing we didn't take off. The left engine isn't working. We're gonna try and get fuel from the right engine to left engine. So if everybody could just lean to left.
All right, that's your audio vault for today. Let's reach over here and lovingly grab the handle, but firmly give it a tug. Keep all that sound inside. All right, coming up, we're gonna get stupid with your stupid criminals in the news, and then we've got some good news for you. This portion of our broadcast is brought to you in part by Jersey Mike's Subs.
At Jersey Mike's, they slice your order fresh right in front of you. And let me tell you, watching that can send a rush of emotions through a person. Excitement, impatience, baby-like wonder, indecisive, anticipatory chewing, nervous pacing, happy claps, and finally, jealousy, because that's this guy's sub. I should order one. Good idea.
Sliced right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing. A sub above.
Hi, I'm Matt Bright, the new owner of CRI Digital Impressions, and I'm excited to announce a new chapter in the century-long history of CRI. Mutual Press was founded in 1927, and in 1973 it merged with CRI to become CRI Mutual Press. In 2002, it was renamed CRI Digital Impressions. I also own Bright Images, which has provided print and media services to the area since 1995. Yes, there is a new owner and a new location, but the same commitment to quality and service. In fact, quality and service are the cornerstones of my business philosophy. Quick turns and service with a smile. From business cards to banners and pamphlets to paperback books, we can provide all your printing needs. Call, visit us online, or stop by our location at 3022 Memorial Avenue, Lynchburg. We look forward to serving you.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle. Trade in with us and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF! Okay, time once again for stupid criminals in the news. Here, let's get rid of that. Everybody knows it's impossible to get in and out of Starbucks within a reasonable amount of time, and that's assuming there isn't a bike lock on the door. Anyway, well, police in Louisiana arrested a 23-year-old man named James Thrash on Wednesday after he closed the front door to a Starbucks and locked it from outside using a bike chain, with employees and customers still inside. Everyone inside was alarmed for several seconds, then they exited out another door. It looks like there were at least two other exits along with the drive-through window. It's unclear what James's point was. He was apparently in the Starbucks earlier and was asked to leave for some reason. James is facing charges for terrorizing and false imprisonment. And then there is this. An Uber driver in California is being accused of saying sexual things to a passenger and showing lewd pictures to her. Here's the victim's friend, Maribel Aguiar.
It's been very traumatic for her. Next thing, he's talking to her about sexual things he wants to do to her. So she starts feeling uncomfortable. My heart sunk to my stomach. She was calling me not only to tell me about what happened, but also to warn me because my daughter takes Uber every day to work as well.
Yikes. An apartment complex in Texas is charging a dead woman over $15,000 for breaking her lease when she died. Here's her son, David Natterman, talking about what had happened.
The fact that they're attacking, coming after the next of kin, who, quite honestly, we loved our mom and we're still grieving, and all they care about is the money. And we went to the apartment complex, spoke with the leasing manager. He told us that he would use the security deposit towards the cleaning and turning over the apartment, and that they would terminate the lease. They want the rest of the about a year's long worth of rent from a dead person.
Good Lord. A woman in New Jersey was caught on video at a zoo, reaching her hand into a tiger cage and almost getting bitten. Here is a zoo employee talking about what she did.
A visitor decided to climb our safety visitor fence and attempt to pet the tiger. And it just was very careless, a very careless action. I hope that the individual recognizes how lucky they were to still be, you know, have all of their limbs.
Good Lord. There's good news in the world, and we like to share it during this particular segment because there is so much stupidity. A guy in Massachusetts delivered his wife's baby on the side of the highway this month after they couldn't quite make it to the hospital. During the delivery, the dad lost his wedding ring on the side of the highway, so he went back and forth and found it with a metal detector. Here is Danya and Rebecca Mahoda talking about this amazing delivery.
We got in the car. The GPS said 56 minutes. One contraction later, he had pulled over to the side of the road. I was already holding her head.
Boy, we made it 26 minutes into that 56-minute trip.
Yep.
My wife is an absolute legend.
Just went back to where my daughter was born on the side of Route 6 and found my wedding ring, which apparently had come off my hand during the delivery. Very happy ending to a very happy story.
Wow. And there you go. That is the good news. The good news is brought to you in part by the United Way of Central Virginia.
Well, being on the board is an amazing experience because you get to find out a lot about the community and what the needs of the community are. United Way is in the business of changing lives.
43,669 of our neighbors cannot afford the basic costs of living. United Way programs were able to provide 99,500 meals to families.
I am the change.
Visit our website, Be the Change, and donate today.
Visit UnitedWayCV.org for more information, and you can visit HillCitySlide.com. Yep, it's here tomorrow and Sunday. Hill City Slide is coming to Lynchburg August 24th and August 25th. To downtown Lynchburg on Church Street between 12th and Washington. A 700-some-foot water slide is coming to the Hill City. And you can register at hillcityslide.com. You can purchase your tickets as well. Both Saturday and Sunday still has time slots available. So get your tickets now before they sell out. And that's all available. You can find out more at hillcityslide.com. While you're downtown, at Hill City Slide, we encourage you to join us at Three Roads Brewing for our Summer Jam event. It's three great bands. It's celebrating the fourth anniversary of Three Roads Brewing in Lynchburg. Here, let me find all the. There we go. Pull up that graphic. It's also the 55th anniversary of Woodstock, so we have Woodstock-themed bands. Bigfoot County as our headliner, Old Town Connector, and Elizabeth Wise will all be playing tributes to Woodstock. We've got our Shakedown Street vendors from the Love LYH Market. There are actually more than that, over 20 vendors, closer to 30. Vendors will be there. Plus, we've got 5 food trucks. It's an all-day event. All-day outdoor music festival at Three Roads, 1300 Court Street in downtown Lynchburg. Best part? Well, there's lots of best parts, but best part, it is absolutely positively free. You don't have to pay anything to get in to Summer Jam 24, right up the hill from Hill City Slide. Three Roads Brewing, 1300 Court Street in downtown Lynchburg tomorrow, August 24th. Noon, it starts and it goes until probably wrap up around 11 or so. So that is it. Oh, by the way, and it is family friendly and it is pet friendly. So come on out, make plans to join us at least part of the day for Summer Jam 24 at Three Roads Brewing, 1300 Court Street. That is it. No, that isn't it, because tonight we're also going to be down at the Glass House. It's the local call band. It's their album release party. So you can join us down at the Glass House. We'll be broadcasting live and on location to support their album release party. And you can check out Three Roads down there as well. We're going to have some choice beverages for you to enjoy. So come and join us tonight at Glass House, tomorrow at Summer Jam, also at Hill City Slide tomorrow and Sunday. There. Did I cover everything? That is it. That is it. That is the show. We are back Monday.
Goodbye.
Don't come back.
Yeah, we're back Monday with another thrilling edition of The Mike Show. Have a great weekend, everybody.
Thanks for tuning our way. And if you're listening in your car right now, thanks for the ride.
Scotty, beat me up.
So this is it. This is the end. I hope you and your companion had a good time listening. And hey, if things went really well, do me a favor and name the baby Ron.
Mike.
Ciao.
Ladies and gentlemen, the weekend.
Who's going to do the dishes?